Neural Rendering the Metaverse, Exploring Next Generation AI-Driven Techniques. In this talk, we are going to explore digital twins, neural radiance fields, virtual production, and generative AI. These pioneering tools will help the next wave of content creators build compelling shared online experiences in the metaverse. I'm Andrew Hazelden, a Nova Scotia, Canada-based visual effects artist. I specialize in high-performance computing. I've contributed to NASA and ESA, European Space Agency planetarium movies about the International Space Station and missions to Mars. As a developer, I created pre-visualization tools that helped Lucasfilm bring the Battle of Scarif to the big screen in the blockbuster movie Star Wars Rogue One. Metaverse in entertainment. Cultural references that drive imagination. Movies that have expanded our imagination and shown what a metaverse experience of the future might look like include The Matrix, Inception, Tron Legacy, and Ready Player One. Social online game platforms are home to millions of players. The games we play online provide countless hours of entertainment, redefine our sense of community, and allow us to express ourselves. Digital twins, building a virtual replica of our world. The term digital twin is often used by the urban planning and construction sectors when discussing the creation of high-resolution models of cities. What makes a digital twin different from simply a 3D scan of a location is the way the model is fed with real-time sensor data that is constantly updated. This allows for an internet-connected digital model of the real world. City-scale and country-scale visualizations are typically driven by high-resolution photo data sets that come from a mix of commercial satellite image providers and airplane or drone-based photos. This information is processed to create digital models of buildings, roads, and vegetation. Leading suppliers of this type of geographic data are Google Earth, Cesium, and Maxar Synth 3D. Google Maps has integrated neural rendering for immersive views. This makes neural radiance field technology something that billions of people will experience in an effortless fashion as we navigate our daily lives. When building digital twins, multispectral imaging extends our reality beyond the visible domain. This allows for intricate and detailed representations of the world around us, and it makes it possible to see the environment in new ways, such as FLIR thermal imaging, UV light, sonar mapping, and radar. 3D tiles. GIS tools like Cesium make it possible to quickly stream map data over the web using the 3D tile specification. Level of detail systems allow for progressive loading of models. This supports dynamic mesh resolution adjustments that optimize the scene as the observer moves closer or further from objects. Real-world capture tools. LiDAR and photogrammetry technology have made the process of scanning the world around us possible with incredible levels of detail and realism. Digital twins aren't limited to urban environments these days. Efforts are underway to map the underground world of caves, tunnels, and other harsh environments. If you want to recreate the feeling of presence and immersion when scanning a location, make sure to also capture the soundscape of the space. Neural radiance fields. Machine learning-driven multi-view rendering. In a short time span of 3 years, a concept called NeRF, which stands for neural radiance fields, has grabbed the attention of computer vision researchers and 3D artists. Neural radiance fields are another way to describe a scene in 3D that allows for 6 degrees of motion inside the virtual space. Leading tools for NeRF rendering include NVIDIA's Instant NGP toolset, Luma AI running on mobile devices, and NeRF Studio. If you want to get started with NeRF concepts, Luma AI makes mobile NeRF capture easy. Virtual production. Mixing reality with the imaginary. Over the last decade, film studios have embraced virtual production techniques that allow for in-camera effects. This means the backgrounds in movies are frequently rendered from digital environments. The Cinegrace virtual production stage at Istad Studios in Sweden uses laser projectors to create a seamless background for film and TV production. Virtual production works by tracking the motion of the on-set camera. The digital backgrounds are rendered in real time through the use of a game engine and then played back on a giant LED video wall or laser projected screen. VP can be traced back to classical rear screen projection techniques used in the golden age of Hollywood filmmaking. Generative AI, synthesizing visuals with machine learning. Generative AI tools allow for art-directed image, video, and 3D model creation. Ideas can be rapidly visualized in seconds by entering a few words in the form of a prompt. Your first experience with generative art tools will likely involve Midjourney, OpenAI DALL-E, and Stable Diffusion. In-painting is used to fill in gaps or holes in an image. This technique builds on earlier approaches like content-aware fill. Out-painting is used to extend the canvas border outwards to expand artwork beyond the original visible frame edge. The use of prompts and a region of interest window allows for precise control over the generated output. These techniques speed up the creation of digital matte paintings, which are usable as background environments in 3D scenes. Style transfer is a technique used to apply different art styles to existing imagery. This allows photos to be turned into painterly artwork. It is an exciting time for computer vision and machine learning research. Every week, something new is discovered. I hope this presentation has given you an overview of the many avenues to explore. Thanks for watching.